I think we can start. Good afternoon. Thanks for coming. Last year I was here to talk about custom fields in Drupal 8. It's not a mistake, just one word missing there, okay? It's been changed to custom entities in Drupal 8. Right. I'm Deji Akala and I work for Capgemini UK. And I've been in the Drupal world since the days of 4.something, that was late 2005, early 2006. So I've seen the transition from 4 to 5 to 6 to 7 and to 8 now. Before we look at custom entities, let's talk about the entity itself. What's an entity? Well, you can say it's a thing or an object, right? And you can also consider that as something that has property and behavior. So it's just like a class, you know? And a couple of years ago, there was a long discussion on that issue, use the term entity instead of object, right? And that's because they couldn't decide whether to go for object, class, entity. And if you trace the history of entities in Drupal, it started from the days of FlexiNode, and then CCK, then fields. Oh, that's a good idea. You can just create something, a content type, add fields, and then that made life a lot easier. Then, the idea of fields, then graduated towards entities, and then talk about fieldable entities and non-fieldable entities. However, Drupal 8 has sort of brought entities to a different level altogether. And then you find different types of entities, things like nodes, users, blocks, comments, everything is now entity, right? So it seems as if everywhere you look in Drupal 8 code, an entity jumps at you, right? So maybe by the time Drupal 9 comes out, or maybe 10, it's going to be entities everywhere. You can't work without entities. Just like OOP, how should I say now? Purists or gurus see classes everywhere. Even if it's just one line of code, it's a class. So maybe we come to that. Yeah, entities everywhere in Drupal. And Drupal 8 also crystallizes entity types into two, right? There's a config entity type and there's a content entity type. And I would like to think of the config entity type as information about your site, and then content entity as information on your site, something that your users come to visit your site for, no matter what that is. So they come for content, and that's what they've come for, right? So we've got config entity types and also content entity types. And core comes with a number of these config entity types and content entity types. We'll look at what that at config entity type does and at content entity type. So if you were to go on the core modules directory and then search for at config entity type, you see this one, right? Plus some other test types, right? But these are the ones that we actually need. You can see, and then on the other side, you've got the content entity types, right? And if you look closely, you can see block content type on one side, and on the other side, you've got block content. You've got contact form, identity type, contact message as the content entity type for that. There's node type, node. But there are some that have no counterpart. On the other side, user is only content. You can see view config entity type on one side. So That means core has given us a lot been built in. And let's have a closer look at the content entity type. You see, that one you can go from your entity type to your sub-entity type, and then your entity. For instance, node as the entity type, right? When you go to your content types list, in your installation, what you see there is the sub-entity types, right? Things like, it comes with an article and page. Yep, so those are the two that come, right? And then, when you now create a page, create an article, that's just the real entities, like an instance. So, content types can be seen as a bundle of fields, right? A set of fields considered together. So your node is done, and then you've got fields like you've got title, body, image, tags, and comment. That makes your articles. And then for your page, you can have that's just title and body. Maybe you want to create news, right? News can then be title, body, image, and category. Text, where you can just select the terms to tag the news item with. So, node is the entity type. If you want to talk class, is your base class, and then article, the sub-entity type, your content type, your bundle can be seen as maybe subclass or extended class, and then the article itself. If you're an Arsenal fan, maybe the title will be Arsenal, same old, right? So what, that's just the entity or just the class instance. So yeah, right. And the beauty of Drupal 8, and even prior to that, is that you can create your own content type, right? You can create it. And in Drupal 8, it comes with only body field, which is not even required. So you can bin that, right? You can also add fields, right, to that, and you can export them. You know, if I were to go back, you can see field storage config, field config. These are things that you can export, right? The configuration of your site, right? You can bundle fields, right, and then export them, and then you don't have to write code, you don't have to do anything. However, you have to think about the extras that core adds to your content types, things like menu, comment, path. Promotion to front page or not front, the author and everything. And country modules may also add some fields that you don't know about, right? So, some people say, where? I can use nodes everywhere. So that means I can just form alter out all those things that are not required. You don't want comments, you don't want things like menu, path. I can always form alter them out. What's all this fuss about entity then? Well, that's not cool. And also the code still gets brought anyway. You're only hiding some of the effects of that. Right. So we've come to the point now that there are some ways in which we can still use nodes everywhere, but we don't want to go that route. We just want to go with our entities. You want to write your own custom entities. So how do we then start? We'll go over something that I've been working on for some time. It's still sandbox. It's gradebook application in Drupal 8. So, and one of the things to consider there is how to record grades, right? How to record grades. For instance, you've got A star, okay? which is a distinction, and then you've got A, very good, and then B, and then C, and then EF. It's not always that a letter is used for grades, right? I know that in Polish, we don't use letters. We have 6, selujące, and then 5, bardzo dobre. But then that's also complex because you've got 5+, you've got 4 minus, 4+, 4. So these we count as our letters. Just have that at the back of your mind. And there's a much dreaded 2-. You see? So you also need to think about the grade ranges, right? For instance, maybe maths 101, you can say 90 to 100 is your A star. But for 3-1, oh, it's 95 to 100, that's your A star. So you need to find a way in this gradebook application to specify different ranges for the same letters, and then group them together, right? So we've now come up with these two, right? Great letter set. That's a group of letters, right? That maybe from 0 to 100. Maybe you can have 5 ranges there of letters. And then for a different course, you want to have more letters, right? So you've got this grid letter sets, and then the grid letters. So your grid letter sets won't really have much. Maybe just the label is enough. So we use config entity for that one. Okay. The config entity type for your grid letter set and for your grid letters will then be content entity type. Okay, what about the fields? Yeah, I've said label for grid letter set should be enough. But for the grid letters, you need the label, you need the description, and also you also need things like the lowest grade, the highest grade, and then weight. Maybe you enter them differently. You want to be able to adjust the weight. There's also the need to allow, if you want to allow others to add fields to your content entity types, that's also something to be considered. So yes, it's possible. So that's another question you need to consider when you're talking about your entity. You want to make them fieldable or not? Then you have to think about the forms, right? For ours, we probably need just add, edit, and then the delete confirmation. And then lists, we also have to have a way of managing the lists, right? And where you can have the list of grid letter sets, and then you can add anyone, edit or delete as you wish. So, in Drupal 7, you always start to think about this and, oh, there's a module for that. I like that. Last year, I mentioned it too, okay? So, and in your custom module, you have to think of hooks to implement, right? There's things like hook entity info, entity property info, the schema that's going to where you inform Drupal about the fields that you about the database schema for your entities, right? And then maybe insert, update, or delete hooks, right? Right. But in Drupal 8, it's a different altogether. So that's somebody gave me this statement after last year's presentation, and I like it. There's a class for that in Drupal 8. You have to think class. Module comes in, but it plays very little role in Drupal 8. Okay, so like I said, you still need your custom module, but for your hooks, in most in most cases, you will now start dealing with annotations. What's that? It's just a comment. A comment that has special meaning in Drupal, right? Even in code generally, you find it in Symfony, Laravel, you find annotations. Yes, you find that everywhere. It's comments with special meaning. So, I'll follow the same pattern as last year. I'll just show you some stubs, and then we'll then look at the code, walk through the code, and if we have time, we can then add a few things to the functionality. So yeah, so that's what an annotation looks like. And see the comment, right? You can see at config entity type there. We'll have a look at that. This just stops, right? It just won't do anything at all. And for the grid letter, you can see the at content entity type there. So that's a good starting point for us. Like I said, there are missing parts, which we will look at later. That Drupal, that namespace, Drupal gradebook entity, that's something that tells Drupal where to find your code. Okay? Right. We're now moving closer towards looking at some code now. So you still need your info file, it's now YAML file, and then you also, the module file is very, very small, as you are going to see. In fact, that's the only hook that needs to be implemented at all for this to work. You can see it's very small. So you end up with something like this. Okay, you can see there's a lot of files there, but we'll have a look at them shortly. Okay, so I hope this works anyway. Okay, so let's have a look at this. Let me just show you the. Yeah, so that's what this looks like now. This is way too big. Sorry about this. I tried to make this smaller. Well, again. No. Okay, so let's just leave it as it is. Command minus. Yeah, let's just leave it. No, it doesn't work. Yeah, it doesn't work. It doesn't work that. Command minus. Let me try it. Let me exit. This didn't work like 2 minutes ago. Oops. Yeah, is that any better? Any better? No. Yeah. Sorry about that. Yeah, you can see. Oof, this is no good. It's no good at all. Command
minus. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I think let's just leave it as it is. Let me just remove these toolbars, right? Let me remove the toolbars. Yeah. Does that look better now? Yes. Good. Okay. Right. So you can see that's all that you need, and then this one that shows the route, and on top of the page, that's what you want there. What you want top of the page when you go to that, right? Now. Where is view? I think I could have just clicked on top there. Okay, good. So here, these are just the parts. What hook menu is going to use now? You now have that in the root file. We shall see what happens. Let's keep this first. Okay. Now the most important file, yeah, is here. So let's start with our grid letter set. That's the config, right? Now, that's just the ID and the label handlers, these are like controllers, controller classes that that's for the access control, that's for the list builder, like when you want to see the list of grid letter sets. And then these, the forms are here. Config prefix, that's when you export, you find the files is named your module dot config prefix, and then the ID of the grid letter set that you've created, we shall see later. Bundle of, so our grid letter set is a config entity, and then the bundles that will be grid letter set we've specified here as grid letter. Okay, the entity keys, that's what identifies the grid letter set. DB, we shall see where that comes in. And then these are links that Drupal will generate for us. And then we shall see how to refer to this later. Let me show you that now. You see? Entity grid letter set list form. Entity grid letter set list form. You can see it here. You can see it. So that's the path. And when you go to that path, you will now see this help text there at the top. And then config export, where you want to export, what would you like to export? This one is just like number one. That's what you've extended. You haven't done anything at all to it. These are just methods that we can comment out, and it still works, right? So of course, interface. Let me remove this interface. You see, it works. Because we only just extended that class. Now, implements grid letter set interface. That's just, I've specified some methods that I want implemented in my class. Let me just quickly show what that's all about. And you can see it here, grid letter set interface. So these methods must be implemented, but they're not essential for my config entity. They're not essential because I just want to find a way of getting all grid letters in a set nicely sorted. And then I just want to get a total of all grid letters, right? Just to demonstrate the possibilities. We shall see where this comes in later. Now, grid letter is more interesting. Yeah, let's have a look. Is that anything? Yeah, I think it's, yes, manageable, okay? Now you can see it's the same pattern, right? That's the one, that entity, the label, you've got the handlers. Now, since we are storing some content, you need to tell core about the so that's the base table, and that's the data table. That's where the fields will now store their data. So you can see these are the entity keys, and then these are the same links, the same type of links, right? And then you want also to say the entity type for this the config entity type for this one, which is what we've specified before. Bundle of was grid letter, and bundle entity type is grid letter set. Okay, are we doing for, all right. So, now these aren't the only entity annotation properties you can specify. I'll show you where you can find the others. You can see it's also the same, you've extended the content entity base. Remember, content entity type, you extend content entity base, and then as best practice, you also have to implement your interface. This is just a bunch of getters and setters for our properties, right? Remember, we're talking about properties and behavior earlier on. These are just getters and setters, but this is what needs to be implemented. If I comment this out, you see that it's going to tell me something is missing. You can see? So to tell me, it says, class must be abstract or implement method-based field definitions because I've extended that class, okay? And these, fields I've defined here are my base fields, right? It's possible to also define default fields per bundle. Then you need to implement a different method. That's called bundle field definitions. I think that's what that method is called. So you can see base field definition, that's the type, and then you've got the label, the description, settings. Let me show you. You can also create entity reference fields. And this one is for the grid letter set. Here, display options for the form. You've got the view, display options, how you want them displayed. If you want, do you want this field configurable from your field display? I'll show you that when you've got manage fields, manage form display, manage view display. We shall see that in a second. So this field will now appear in that list. And that's your lowest, and that's your highest, and that's your weight, and some other things that you need, right? Okay, so this method is the only one that's required, right? That's where you define your fields, right? And so you don't need to worry about exporting your field configuration, your field storage config, right? You define them here, and when you enable this model, these fields will be automatically created for you. Okay, so that's that one. Now, I promised to show where you can see the annotations. If you go to lib Drupal core, right, and you go to entity, you see something here, annotations, right? If you go to config entity type, you don't see much here. However, if you read the comments, it says annotation properties of entity types are found on Drupal core config entity type. So you then go there, it says config entity type. You can see it here. So you don't see much here. You can see config prefix, config export. These are the properties you want exported, the ones we specified earlier on. But if you look at extends, you will see a lot more. You can see entity keys. That's the key of when you were looking at the annotations earlier on. You saw the entity keys, right? You see your ID, you see your class, there's more here, handlers, array, links. So if you go through here, you will see properties that you might be interested in defining. You can see label, callback, bundle, entity type, bundle of. You can see all those ones. So that's where you find the annotations that you can use there. Okay. Let's quickly enable this because time's really going. Gonna, not a good day to be a gonna. let's go to DCL. By the way, I've set up this before. Hopefully it doesn't crash and burn. Oh, yes, we've got that. Oh. It's not behaving very well at all. Yeah, this is not the best. However, if you go to configuration here, you see grid letters, right? So you can see the total letters that was calculated for us in that class. You can see default. I'll show you where that default is from in a second. Yeah, I'm just conscious of time, you see. So we can list grid letters. There's no grid letter for us to see here. Yes. Now, I didn't show you whether I didn't tell you there's going to be default grid letters, did I? No, I didn't, because I forgot. Now, let's go back. Yeah. Of course, we know configuration files are, they go in this in this folder, config. So on install, whatever is here will now be created for you. So we can see module set, which is the config prefix, we set the layer on, default, that's the ID of this grid letter set, which is. And there is something that needs to be done. You need to tell Drupal about the schema for that something. That says now this has the ID here. It's type a string and the label is ID, label is just mapping. That's to describe what's in this, what's here, right? Okay, so when you install your module, you then see that it goes through that config folder, and whatever is there, it installs it for you. So that's why we got that. So, and I said earlier on that list of all grid letter sets, that's what's in the hook help that we implemented earlier on for this something. So yeah, here, list grid letters, there is none. So let's add one. My favorite, excellent, lowest, maybe we say 94.99, highest 100, which I don't think anybody can score if you're in my class. So right, so let's just add this one. Let's quickly add a B. Maybe B, let's just put that as 80, 85, it doesn't really matter, whatever we put there, I just want to demo something. Oh, and then, oh yes, we need an A, we've forgotten an A. So let's put that as maybe, was that, did we have 94? It doesn't matter, anyway, this is just a demo, so let's have 85. We can put anything there.
Should be other.
Yeah. Let's just leave it like that. Just want to show that this can be. So you drag that. You drag that. Okay. Yeah. So it stays where it was before. And then when you. Yeah, you can see three is there. That's total grid letters. You can add a different grid letter set for, let's say, Drupal, yeah, you kind of maybe have maybe you're running a Drupal course, right? And then you can, yeah, we don't have, so there's no grid letters, there's no grid letters for that one. Yeah, you can see, so that way you can bundle grid letters into sets and use them as you like, okay? I also, yes, I think I should just demo this quickly. Now you can see here, it simply says grid letters, yeah? If you go back, it says grid letters, but it doesn't tell you anything. So what we need is to do something. This is just, let's just move this, okay. You know what? I've got so grid letters list form, where are you written? So in fact, this way you can change page titles, isn't it? Let's say list, right? Grid letters set list form, yeah? I think it's this one, hopefully. So you're now saying, so title callback, where you want to generate the page title, run the code here. In this class, run that method, the page title. So you can see that's a grid letter controller. Okay. You know what? Sorry, guys. I think because we changed that path, so let's just do this one. By the way, the code for this demo, I'll show you where you can find it. There are some other things that this is just introduction and to walk you through the code. There are lots of things that we've not considered, we've not covered at all here. So if we go here now, that one is there now. So that tells you where that one is. And then here, yeah, it's not too good. This will tell us is default, yeah? It's a default, so you can then add some for that one. One quick thing, you know, we were talking about fields, right? To allow, there's nowhere here for you to add fields to anything, right? To the grid letters, right? Yeah? But we want to be able to sort of do that. Let's quickly have a look at that. You need to do something to your annotation. You need to add a key there. Grid entity is here. Letter, yeah. Because you want this field override. So that when you want to edit a grid letter set, so you want to be able to add fields to the grid letters in that set. Okay, so we shall see how that works. So that's all you need to define there. However, before you can see the links, when you visit that page, there's something you need to add to. Yeah, that's still empty now for the tasks, right? That's for secondary tabs in 7, 6, that kind of thing. So that's now, you can then sort them out here in your YAML file here, links task. So let's quickly, how are we doing for time? Humberto? Oh, okay, that's no good. But we can still see that. So we see that, so these are just the two places you need to change. because we did the annotation change, we can just do something like that. So let's go here now. Hopefully, there's something there, yeah? You can see, manage my form display, you can see everything. Ah, yes. When you go there, it says no fish present yet. It tells you, you can do anything yet. You see? Description, lowest, highest. These are your base fields, right? You can only change them. You can only change the order because remember the view display options in that bundle field definition? We said true. That doesn't actually want them to be able to change the order here. So let's make something happen. Let's make something happen. Let's add something here. Let's just add, I hope this works because yesterday, let's say Drupal camp field. Let's just say, it doesn't matter. Hey, it's there, yeah, good. Yeah, so that's that. Now, you can see form display. So you cannot change it, you cannot change the text style or whatever you like, yeah. And you can see that here, you can drag and drop anywhere you like and save. Yes. That's the demo, that was very, fast, but yeah, we've seen step by step how to tackle this problem. Now, practically, how did I get into this, into fields, into entities, Drupal 8? What I did was a couple of years ago when Drupal 8, when there was some momentum of code released, I found two contribute poll and profile. Right, that was taken out of Drupal 7 core. I worked on them as core was being changed. I was just learning as I went along, trying to make them work, right? So I adopted those two modules, and then as the code became stabilized, I was upgrading some of my own modules, right? I created a couple, a country field, a language field, plus a couple of others, right, that are available. Address field also, simple address field for Drupal 8. And also, like I said, I've got a personal project called PHP Edu, right, that's supposed to be Moodle for Drupal, right? It's coming along, and this gradebook is part of that, so when this proof of concept works, then I can then upgrade the sandbox to a real model, right? So these are different ways I've adopted to learn to get into Drupal 8 and also speaking too. So if you are going to speak, then you have to show something, right, that works. And luckily for me today, it has worked. So so more of that, yeah. So. Let me quickly show you. In fact, this is not the only thing for, yeah, I hope he doesn't mind. Let me show you a couple of other things. Like I was saying, let's just use this window. We're not coming back here. So for gradebook, there is still a lot of concepts that have not been covered in this. Yeah, let's have a look at this. So you can see there are more entities like a grade category, item, grade score, lots of other stuff, right? Grade scale. So if you're into education and you're thinking about Drupal 8 something, right? Yeah, talk to me afterwards, right? There's stuff that you can work with. Good. Good. So, you find the some that's media. I kind of like the book this year, 2016. And for the code that I quickly showed you, you find a bunch of modules there for that. Take it, it's free, open source. Yes, I do the cool stuff too, Twitter, all this stuff, even though I don't tweet regularly, you know. But yeah, you can see me there, you know. Yeah. Once again, thanks for coming. Yes.